Lurch. You're that kid killer Moran was talking about, aren't you?
Please, you're hurting me.
Well, you wanted to know where the dunny was. I'll have to show you how to use it, hey? Hold your breath, kid killer.
Try not to upset them. They'll come round, I'm sure.
I wish I had your confidence.
Oh, I just can't go.
Hey. Hold on, hold on. I'll see if I can organise a few double shifts. I'll do everything I can to help you.
Lexie, get away from that tray.
Shut up. Oh, bloody hell, rack off.
You're told not to touch Kelly's food. Heavens, girl, what are you trying to do, kill her?
It's what she bloody well deserves, isn't it?
I've a good mind to tell the governor.
Hey, Luke, how you doing?
What do you reckon? How come you're back up here?
Got lucky. Had myself put up here so I could talk to you about something. Figured out a way of getting out of here using a screw.
Oh, forget it. Ferguson won't touch it. There's no other screw bent enough.
So we bend him.
Who's him?
Moran. Just found out he's got a secret.
Mess up first.
Oh, come on, Nance. We're a wreck. We don't have much time.
Nancy is right. Go grab a bucket, Lex.
Why me?
Oh,
I'll
do it. Lexie's better at decorating.
Come on, girls.
Good on you,
get
children.
Get those trays.
Take
that.
We'll get
this
table.
I'm saving it for these.
Oh, geez,
hey, that stupid Williams will miss out on all the goodies. That serves the bitch right.
She must have been pretty desperate to get out of here.
Yeah, I wonder why.
Hey, well, that Maxwell bitch better try the same stunt then, huh?
Hey, yeah, what are you going to do to her, Rita?
I don't know, but whatever it is, it's going to be good. Come on, let's stick these things up.
OK, I'll help Rita with these. You do the balloons.
Oh, but I can't do them all by myself. Look, there's hundreds of them.
Don't worry about it. We'll spread them around during work period.
Oh, hurry up, Chuck. Hey, get into the hand.
Hey,
Lexie,
do you want to go around or across?
Oh, Bud, hit that in the side.
No worries. Go and get us some stickers.
Lurch!
Is this high enough?
Yeah, beauty, Lurch!
Rita?
Hey, you've got any tape over there?
Yep. What about the bitch?
Was it not a nagging rule? She didn't know anything about it.
She will when I finished with her.
Yeah, bloody good thumping and straighten her out.
We're supposed to be
well, look, if we tell her about the rule and why we have it, she won't do it again.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Bloody hell,
I can't trust anyone who'd kill their own kid,
you heard what happened from Mr. Moran.
She's not exactly sound and sorry, is she?
Lurch, if you don't come and get her,
I'm coming. Oh, now what am I going to use?
Oh, there's some more in here.
Oh, good. Break us up a bit, will you?
Well, maybe she just doesn't want to talk about it. I know I wouldn't.
Nance, will you give it a rest?
No, because she's really suffering and she shouldn't be. The least you can do is leave off belting her or whatever you have in mind until she knows the ropes, please.
I don't know why I got Dan the man that job. You could take the pulpit any day.
I promise me, until at least I can explain the no lagging.
Oh, all right, just to get you off me back. You're too bloody soft for your own good, Nance. That's your trouble. You just tell her what she's in for if she tries anything again, okay?
Thank you.
Oh, now the thing's not sticking. Have a bloody hell to get that stuff to stay up.
Okay? No, longer. Longer?
There's got to be more than mates the way he was talking. Lou? We're both gone, right? You hear? Don't you bloody try without me.
Oh, shut up, will you? Want the whole bloody place to hear you?
I told you about it. You can't take off without me.
All right, now shut up, will you?
Just think. Could be out of here tomorrow.
Sure. Just you leave it to me.
Oh, what? Come on, this is the work bell. Where's my bloody lunch?
You're not missing much. Just think of the grub we can get on the outside. Hamburger with the lot. Haven't had one in yonks. What do you reckon, Lou?
Isn't that why I'm settling myself with a drunk guy like you, Williams?
Hey, he's itching to know what we're cooking, isn't he?
He probably already knows. Hey, watch this. Hey, Lou, where do you keep the custard powder? We need it for the marinade.
You don't use custard powder.
I told you, Jack.
Cheeky devil. What's up?
My blood pressure for a start. Thank heavens I don't get married every day.
Kelly's tray ready?
Yes, it's here. All right, girls, what have you done with Luke Kelly's tray?
Oh, Nancy stuck it in the cool room.
I'll go get it for
you. No, you don't. I'll get it. Thank you very much.
I need a hand taking it upstairs, Mr. Moran.
Not very subtle, Patterson. Anyway, after tomorrow, it won't matter.
Tomorrow?
That's what I said. Thank you. Don't overdo it.
It was our last chance. Bitch. Hey, maybe we could get a message to Blackmore somehow.
Are you putting in a bit much, aren't you?
I am not.
Well, give it here, Lois.
I know what I'm doing. Don't steal, bloody killer.
What do you want?
It's all right. I just came to give you some advice. Some helpful advice. Sit down. Look, I know just what you're going through. I haven't been here long myself.
You had trouble?
A little, but luckily I was told about the no-lagging rule before I put my foot in it.
Yes, I realize I shouldn't have said anything now.
Oh, it takes some adjusting. I haven't come to terms with some of the women's attitudes myself, but I'm beginning to understand them.
It's so unreal in here.
It's hard for everyone when they first arrive.
What are you in for?
Ah, now that's something else we don't do, love. We don't ask a person's crime.
Oh, sorry. There's so much to learn just to survive.
Well, I'll help you. If you let me.
Thanks, but I don't...
No, I don't just mean with the rules, Kath. But if you don't unburden yourself soon, you're going to crack.
What do you mean?
You're bottling it all up, aren't you? Now, it'd help to talk to someone about why you killed your daughter, I mean. Listen to me, Kath. I know you must have loved her very much to do as you did. Because no mother in her right mind would ever deliberately murder her child.
Don't worry, Kelly. Nobody's forgetting you.
Back against the wall.
So, where's your slave labor, then?
I didn't want anybody getting to you before the law does, Kelly.
Bit of a come down for the ex-governor, innit?
Heard what happens to you at Blackmore if you give lip?
No, I'm not going anyway.
I got news.
No other news for you, Moran.
Well, you Kath Maxwell's got herself a protector. You.
Oh, shut the door.
I'm sure you don't want to be overheard. Again.
Who fed you this crap, Williams?
Could be. Maybe I found a note in my Wheaties.
I mean, you've been a real blabbermouth, I hear.
Wherever you got it from, you're not holding it over me. No one would buy it for a second.
Start asking questions, eh, wouldn't they?
Assuming they do. What's the deal?
You give me enough funds to leave the country and I'll keep my mouth shut. And I'll give you the name who told me.
I'm sure you could find a way to shut her up.
All so easy, isn't it?
Yeah, well, it's better than seeing your girlfriend copping up when you're not around to protect her. Oh, and Reynolds finds out about this little relationship of yours, you'd be out of here in 2 seconds flat.
It's been enlightening.
Too much time making up your mind. See, I might just tell her anyway. I can't do worse than I already am.
with bells on. Well, he's promised something a little more upmarket anyway.
Must have taken some persuading.
Not really.
Meg, you haven't picked up any undercurrents of anything happening with the women, have you?
No, how do you mean?
Oh, nothing, just something dancing. Hello, Bob. You're going to check the chaos in the kitchen.
I'm the only one getting nervous, eh?
Actually, it looks like it's full steam ahead.
Good. Kelly's transfer. What time does that happen?
10 o'clock tomorrow.
Don't worry about the papers, Bob. I'll organise them before I finish tonight.
Right. Well, I think I'll avoid the battle zone. Last thing Merv needs is an officer to trip over.
Bob.
I can't stay long. It's bad news, I'm afraid.
What is it?
Luke Kelly. Somebody overheard us talking and told him she's using it to try and blackmail her way out of here.
She's getting you to help her?
No way I'll fall for that one.
But what are you going to do? I mean, if the governor finds
out... I'll handle Kelly. I just want you to be prepared in case I have to leave on the spur of the moment.
But you're not thinking of helping her, are you, Bob?
No. And the less you know, the better. It's just that if I do have to leave, you'll be prepared.
I talked to Nancy. She's going to try and make the other women understand.
Good. I better go before somebody else overhears us.
I reckon it's going to look all right.
Do you think there'll be enough white ones?
Well, if there isn't, we'll stick the coloured ones on the screws table. Give them a bit of blue for a change.
Oh, God.
Don't tell me you forgot to order the keg.
I just remembered. Steve's coming. I'm going to have to perform in front of him.
I'll laugh, even if you fall on your face.
Yeah, what if I make a fool of myself?
You're going to be a knockout, Chook. I don't know what you're worried about anyway. I got an MC and I've never done it before in my life.
Yeah, but you know stacks of jokes and stuff.
Yeah, but I can't tell him in front of the screws, can I? Well, I could.
The tables look terrific. Yeah, we really need place cards, but maybe Lex could do some.
There's no time.
Do you want a hand with the rest?
No, we got it down to a fine art.
Yeah, next one.
Thanks,
Joan. Look, Rita, I had a talk with Kath Maxwell, and I filled her in on the rules.
She's going to wake up to herself?
Now she understands, yes. And, you know, she told me what drove her to kill her daughter, too.
And sucked you right in, I bet.
I believe her, yes.
No offence, Nance, but you'd believe any bloody sob story. The bitch is running scared. It's as simple
as
that.
Well, if she is, she won't be doing it alone.
What are you doing here, McCormack?
Well, I
get to the kitchen, or you'll be scrubbing floors. You two, back to the laundry.
We can't. We got to finish this.
Yeah, we got permission, Miss Ferguson.
Right, you've got 5 minutes to finish up.
Oh, come on, crack a grin. It's not our fault you're not invited tonight. We'll save your doggy bag, right?
Jeez, Rita.
It's all right, she won't try anything today. Reno wants it to go without a hitch.
Yeah, well, there's always tomorrow.
Will you shut up? You start wimping like Nance, I'll dong you.
Sounds like Nance is really digging in with Kath, doesn't it?
Yeah, bugger her. It's always some bloody underdog for her to go sticking up for.
What's the matter, Maxwell?
Nothing, Miss Ferguson.
Then stand up when I talk to you.
Sorry.
I bet you are. Someone been giving you a hard time, have they?
No. No, Miss Ferguson.
Looks like they got their message across anyway. And from what I hear, they're going to be teaching you a lot more. Moran's pep talks aren't going to help the likes of you, Maxwell.
It's not Bob's fault. Mr. Moran went out of his way to help. He didn't really have to, considering his position.
No. But then perhaps he has a personal interest.
I wouldn't know. He said he'd been to Vietnam. Perhaps that's why.
This one's from Jesse Wyndham. When did it come?
Pardon? Not sure. Maybe Steve. You heard the good news?
Yes, must go and visit her as soon as the wedding's over. Here comes the mad scramble. Well, I'll see you later. Oh, Joan, do you know if the women's costumes have arrived yet?
No, I do not. I just saw the Maxwell woman. Looks like she's been roughed around a bit.
Badly?
Oh, not that you'd notice.
Well, we all expected it. Maybe I should talk to them again before they do some real damage.
Taking a rather unusual interest, aren't you?
Just doing my job. A lot better for all of us. We stop trouble before it starts.
Whatever you say.
Yes. Well, duty calls.
Oh, no, Alice, we don't have time for that.
Oh, but it'll give it a bit of class. It's supposed to be a special dinner.
Yeah, the spud soup could do with a bit of tartan up.
Something's burning.
Bloody hell, I was supposed to do
that.
Oh,
I'll fix it. Come here and help me.
No,
I'll do it.
I don't mind.
No, you go off and have a tea break or something. Now go and do your shopping list for next week.
I've just got a job.
The only thing you're allowed to do with this meal is to sit back and enjoy it. Oh, girls, could you take the cutler into the dining room, please? And Alice, dear, I told you we don't have time for croutons. The parsley'll dress it up.
What's all this stuff?
Oh, Alice, I thought you'd done it.
What?
The mousse, the chocolate mousse. It'll never be ready in time.
Oh, geez, I'm sorry, Nance. Look, I'll do it in a minute, as soon as I've finished this.
I blow the croutons.
Oh!
Alice, I am sorry. No, we'll do them later if we have time. Lexie, where are you going?
Oh, I've just had a great idea. I'll be back in a minute.
Oh, it's okay, Nance. We'll get it all done. No worries.
The answer is no.
But I haven't said anything yet.
You don't have to. You've been coming up with ridiculous suggestions all afternoon.
Merv, I just wanted to ask if I could make a few extra mousses for the officers who'll miss out on the fun. Now, what is ridiculous about that?
I think it's a wonderful idea.
Okay, then.
I only hope Miss Ferguson appreciates the gesture.
Yeah.
Sorry I snapped. I'm a bit tense.
Give it back, you big dummy!
Yes, keep the noise down.
That means you, Stuart.
I can't see Lexie's in mine.
Oh, come on. Oh, no, be careful. Be careful. Don't forget they're rented.
You're telling me I could smell the mothballs from 10 miles away. Oh, beauty.
Look at this. Are they a bit short?
Oh, I think they're Lexie's. You'll have to look for ones with your name on them. I think they've all got a name on them.
This is great, Mrs. A.
Hey, whose are the frills? Lurch? Oh, bloody hell! Yeah, she wanted an authentic waitress outfit.
Hey, look, Rita, it's Nancy Chef's hat.
She'll be taken over from Merv before you know it.
Bloody sucker.
Did you say something, Stuart?
Yeah, how come you lot get that stuff and we can only wear civvies?
Because they're working on the dinner.
You can do my bit with Lexie if you want to.
Chalk!
Get nicked. I'm not making a bloody galah myself.
Or enough of one already.
Look, you're not getting down on the mouth about this, are you?
Yeah, what's the matter with you? Pre-show nerves.
No, you should see what they're doing. It's real good. I can't wait. Now, where is the rest of McCormack's outfit?
Pat, could you give me a hand with... Oh, damn.
Yeah, I'll give you a hand.
Oh, thank you.
Put it over your head.
Yes, I suppose I could.
Before you go, I'd just like to wish you and Mr. Pringle all the very best for the future.
Oh, thank you very much, Miss Ferguson.
You look smart choice.
Oh, well, I've had it for ages, actually. I'm surprised it still fits.
Looks lovely.
Thank you.
Miss Ferguson, go up and let Williams out of solitary, will you? She's had enough time to think about her outburst.
Just a couple of hours.
I think any more would be rather severe, considering she'll be missing the dinner.
That's right. I forgot. We're back to pampering them, aren't we?
Oh, you must be the new chaplain. How do you do? I'm Joyce Barry.
Sorry, Joyce. Dan Moulton. Joyce Barry.
You don't look a bit like a bikey.
Oh.
Special effort for your celebration tonight.
Oh, dear, I've just had the most awful sinking feeling.
You've forgotten something?
No, it's tomorrow. The wedding. Oh, I've been so busy I haven't even had time to think about it.
Doing going through her
What's
things.
What's it look like?
Now, look, I know the rules now. Nancy,
don't suck an egg, Maxwell. Jessie's my mum, so it doesn't matter, does it?
You might have pulled the wool over Nancy's eyes, but don't think you fool the rest of us for 1 second. Stick it, kid killer!
Nancy? Now, they've all been counted and will be collected straight after the dinner, so there's to be no souveniring,
oh,
right?
Perhaps Mervyn can see to that.
Yes, he's been driving us up the wall, Mrs. M.
I've only been trying to help.
It's all right, Miss Ferguson will pop in during her rounds.
Well, I suppose I'd better go and get changed.
Good. Now, ladies, there's not much time. Just remember, you're on trust, any trouble, and you'll ruin it for everyone else.
Yes, Mrs. Morris.
Hey, Nan. Hey, look, I'll put this over by the door, okay, so it'll be ready.
Yes, well, when you come back, could you give me a hand with this?
Yeah. Hey. Well, they see this little beauty, eh? Oh!
Bloody hell! Oh, Lurch!
I'll collect both trays.
Right, come on, William.
Don't forget me, Kelly, you hear? That's enough. I'm telling you, Kelly.
That's enough, now move.
Need a William. Hand?
I can manage.
I didn't ask to be let out of here, you bitch.
Give me the tray back against the wall.
Got rid of the noise. Nice one.
Wasn't my idea.
This better be my last meal in here, Moran.
I'll be back, Kelly, when I know the coast's clear.
Oh, jeez. I just don't know how I did it. I mean, Lurch spent hours making it look nice after everything else that's bloody well happened to her today.
It was an accident.
Oh, don't worry about it. We can still save this part.
Oh, we should all stop being so bloody nice.
Oh, all right. It was stupid, clumsy and thoughtless, and you should have watched where you were going, all right? Is that better? You happy?
He's up, Chook.
Here.
What do you reckon?
It's,
Jeez, right? You look real different.
Yeah, friends. Oh, sight to frighten the cows, but.
No, it's lovely.
It's perfect for the occasion.
Oh, ta. Oh, anything left of it?
Oh, well, it's not the cake it was. I think it'll pass inspection.
Lurch, I could bloody well kick myself.
Oh, it doesn't matter.
If I were you, I'd knock me block off.
It's just a cake.
Oh, I know, but you spent so long doing it.
Why don't we put the rest of these in the fridge?
Just apologising.
Yeah, well, 50 times is enough. Look what you've done.
You know, she really does feel badly about it.
Yeah, well, what's done's done. Oh, jeez, me mum always used to say that.
Oh, no, Alice, you mustn't start thinking like that today.
Good grief. What are you supposed to be, Jenkins?
Well, we're all dressing up for the occasion, Miss Ferguson.
Yeah, and I'm waiting on the tables.
What happened to that?
Oh, it's my fault. It was an accident.
Yeah, she didn't mean to wreck it, Miss Ferguson.
Suit yourselves. Should be quite an event by the time you lot are through with it.
Oh, bitch.
Jeez. I look a real gog, don't I?
Oh, no, that's not right. You look terrific.
Don't worry. She won't be laughing for long.
Aren't you ready yet? We can't keep them waiting forever.
I've been ready for the last 5 minutes, love.
But they'll be wondering what's happened to us, Mervyn.
No, they won't. The bride's supposed to be late. It's tradition.
No, no, no. That's for the wedding. Well, how do I look?
Oh, you look beautiful.
Mervyn, do you think we're doing the right thing?
Oh, Joycey, not now.
Oh, I'm sorry, dear. I didn't really mean that. I was just being silly.
I thought we might have a little sip.
Mervyn Pringle, what do you think you're doing? You know you're not allowed to drink, especially with your epilepsy.
Just a top to calm the nerves.
Oh, I don't think... Oh, why not? Oh, I do hope we won't be having anything heavy and rich for the meal tonight.
Of course we won't. I mean, I don't know. I'm sure it'll be a very nice surprise.
Oh, it really is very good of the women to do all this for us, isn't it? What? Oh, Mervyn, what have I done with my handbag? Oh.
Use her at this table, ladies. They were here in a minute, ma'am.
No, it's all right. I've nearly finished.
Oh, give them to me. If you don't go and get changed, it'll all be over before you're ready.
Keep your shirt on, Lurch.
There we go.
No, is that everything?
That's all you've got time for. Oh, geez, I knew this had happened. Get those bloody uniforms out of here. They don't look right.
Wow. I never thought I'd see the dining room looking like this.
It's the Wentworth Hilton.
It certainly is.
Oh, good evening, Mrs. Reynolds. Mrs. Morris.
Good evening, Jenkins. Oh, this is Mr. Moulton.
Oh, yeah. Have we met?
Nice outfit.
Oh, thanks. This is really something. You've done wonders.
Oh, yeah, well, everyone put in their two bobs worth. Hey, look, you want to come this way? I'll show you to your seats.
Oh, very nice. Just the right touch of dignity.
Would you
come on? You're here, Mrs. Reynolds. How are you?
And Mrs. Morris down here?
Not bad.
There, yeah, beats checks and denims. Thought I might rip the sleeves out, give me tats a bit of a show.
Yeah, I wouldn't. Not unless you want to pay for the jacket.
Shouldn't you be dressed or something?
I'm on my way right now.
Well, you better hurry up. You don't want to miss the floor show.
Oh, please. I have to talk to you.
Not here, inside.
I
can't stand just sitting here waiting. That woman who overheard us, have you found out what she knows?
It's not that easy. I have to be careful.
Well, at least tell me who it is. I've been sitting here waiting for her to come through the door.
That can't happen.
Those women are capable of anything.
You haven't met Lou Kelly, and you won't. She's in solitary, and she's being transferred out of here tomorrow. It's only what she knows that can do damage. Well, I'll see what I can do. I can't really see any objections to a few personal effects being brought in.
Miss Moran, I thought I'd come and take her to the dining room.
Good idea. I think she needs a friendly face or two.
Are you coming, love?
No, thanks, I couldn't.
Oh, I thought as it's a festive occasion and everyone's in a happy mood, might be a good chance to try and break the ice.
Look, I appreciate it, but I couldn't cope with it just now.
Well, you're going to have to, sooner or later.
Later.
Oh, well, it's up to you. I'll be in the kitchen if you need me.
To hear about the drunk who came to me door at 2 o'clock in the morning.
Now, what
wanted
did he...
to come in.
Now, what did he do? What did you do?
What did I do?
Now, what did you do?
I got out of bed, opened the window, and yelled, "Don't you know you got the wrong house?"
What did he do then, Ollie?
He yelled back, "How do you know you're not looking out of the wrong house?"
Definitely a hit. Hollywood's probably on the phone already.
You weren't standing there listening, were you?
Yeah, of course.
You're so dumb.
You feel dumb. I mean, all you could do is wear this stupid suit and say, "What happened then, Ollie?" I'm the one walking around like a dag and trying to remember the jokes.
Hey, stick with me, kid. I can sell this act anywhere.
Oh, I bet. And where'd you get the threads?
Legacy of my uni days, dressing up for balls.
Must have cost a few, Bob.
You'd have to ask my mother.
Well, I better be going. See you at dinner and good luck.
Yeah.
Sorry. Break a leg. Hey, bye.
Doesn't he look terrific?
Not bad. Reckon Rita's right, he's loaded.
Oh, his family is.
Same thing?
No, it's not. You heard, it's his mother.
So?
What's she gonna think of him going out with someone like me?
Look, we've been through this 100 times. He's nuts about you. End of story. Oh, come on, Stan. You're going to be living in bloody Toorak before you know it.
You're a real sport, you know, letting them do this.
Why? The women ask for it. Why stop them?
Plenty would. They owe you one.
I don't know about that.
I do. Take a look at Rita. Is that trouble on two legs or what?
I think she's about to stand on them and make the announcements. Remember the church grade.
It's better. Okay, on your feet, everyone, for the toast.
Oh, geez.
Here's to the bride and groom, Merv and Mrs. Boone.
Merv and Mrs.
Okay, you can park your bums again. Now, our hostess for this evening is Alice Jenkins. You might have noticed, Alice. We've had a call from Lay Girls already. She's going to be topping up your glasses during the night. And as for the official table, well, a couple of them don't scrub up too badly when they want to. I think that's Dan, the man over there, but I'm not too sure because I've never seen him in his Sunday best before. And as you've noticed, bringing in the tacker, we've got Stan and Ollie. Oh, our very own Jules and Legs. Come on in, girls. And out in the kitchen, cooking a little heart out, is our very own Nance McCormack. Yay! That one's for you, Nance. Okay, everybody. Tucky, you want me to help?
Where's Bob?
Oh, he's probably running a bit late changing. Pity, I think he's missed the best part.
There's still the entertainment.
Oh, mind boggles.
Oh, sorry. Great.
For the occasion, did you? Everything ready? I'm giving you chief fee.
It's all worked out.
You bid not blow this marine.
I won't. There's not another living soul within Cooey.
Fair enough. Then you better give me a few details before we get going, eh?
Go where?
What do you bloody reckon out of here?
That wouldn't really suit my purpose, would it?
What do you mean? We had a deal.
What deal?
You bastard. You wouldn't dare.
I can kill you right now, Kelly. No one to see, no one to hear. Just a corpse.
Like hell. I'm not the only one that knows about you and your girlfriend.
You're going to tell me who that other person is, aren't you?
You're out of your head.
No. Once you've been taught how to kill, you never quite get it out of your system.
Best wishes to you both for a happy future, Jess. There's Pierce. Mrs. Barry, I've put the word out on Mervyn for you. There's not a girl between here and Darwin who'll take his business, so he'll have to come home for it. Did you bring your note, Mr. Moran? Oh, well, Miss Jenkins, ladies and gentlemen, do
this isn't our bedroom.
Hey, listen, find a spot for me.
Where are you going?
Just got to do something.
So, by the time I'd made a couple of phone calls and taken a few more telegrams...
It hasn't stopped all day.
Jeez, I'm buggered if I know how their models can walk around in these things all the time.
Do you think the food's going over all right?
Oh, are you kidding? Who's raving about?
He asked if we'd let him have the recipe. Oh,
would if we could. Most of it was improvised.
Hey, I'll be back in a tick.
Where are you going?
See a man about a doll.
Oh, no, look at us. We've got to do a floor show. What about all this?
We'll do it later.
Oh, hey, can you make sure Miss Ferguson gets a mousse?
Oh, are there enough?
Yeah, it's the one on the end. It's darker. Oh. She's a chocolate freak. I'm putting a bit
very
extra.
Very well, very well.
Anyone see you coming?
No.
Let's go before anyone gets onto us.
Dear Alan, perhaps I can write what happened better than I can say it. I want you to understand what I did and why I did it. It wasn't to hurt you. I love you too much to do that. But I had no choice. Linda was suffering so much.
You all right, Maxwell?
I'm fine, thanks.
Had something to eat?
No, I'm not hungry, thanks.
Suit yourself.
To the establishment, all the way from Mirimbula, one of the world's great comedy acts. So, without any more mucking around, let us welcome here tonight, premiering at Wentworth, the Stan and Ollie Show. Well, it's either stage. stage fright or they've shot through. Oh, don't worry, Gov, we'll get them back for you.
What's going on? Where's me? She's gone to the loo and I couldn't go in there on me. Oh, well, how long is she going to be?
I don't know. She's been gone a while.
Bloody hell, where have you been? You're supposed to be
hiding. Yeah, I had a few hassles organising my pillows.
No. But don't laugh. I was in a uni review once, fainted from stage fright.
What happened?
I came to and there's the dean standing over me, saying, well, if you can't handle this, how's he going to handle casualty?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's see how we go this time. Here we are for your entertainment. We hope the Stan and Ollie Show! Hit it, man! Sorry, Ollie, I'm a chap.
That's all right, Stan. I walk on them all the time. Why shouldn't you? Did you hear about me, Uncle?
Oh, what about me, Uncle?
Your uncle! He bought a water bed to keep the marriage together.
Did it work?
No. They just drifted further apart.
Did it? Oh, do another one. Do another one.
Enjoying yourself, Williams?
Yeah. A real bore.
You don't seem to be having much luck lately. Kelly must be the only friend you've got.
That bitch. Forget it.
Oh, what's this, a falling out amongst thieves?
She'll get hers. I'm sticking to myself from now on.
A flea without a dog to live on. I doubt it, Williams. You're not the type.
Hey, Lex and Chook are going down like a house on fire out there.
Oh, good. I wasn't sure if Mervyn would like some of the bluer jokes.
Oh, he's killing himself. So is Mrs. B.
Everything all right in here?
Going like clockwork, Miss Ferguson.
Just make sure it's all cleaned up by tonight.
Oh, I don't think we can manage.
It wasn't a question, McCormack. It's to be as you found it by lights out.
Oh, there's a chocolate mousse there for you, Miss Ferguson.
Oh, sometimes it's very hard to be charitable.
Yeah, but there's no point in letting it go to waste, is there?
Too, by the look of things, it's to Mr. Mervyn Pringle. There, Mervyn. The kids are missing you, so is the dog. Little Frank's got the mumps and the landlord's been asking about the rent again. They came and took away the telly yesterday and the fridge went last week. All is forgiven. Please come home, your loving wife. Now, I don't want to go jump into any conclusions, Mervyn, but are you sure you haven't let Joyce in on a little thing?
She's got a nasty cut on her head, and when I found her, she was right out to it, so she's probably concussed as well.
Where is she now?
In the staff room.
What about her keys?
Still on her. I don't think it's a breakout, Mrs. Reynolds, not as far as I can see.
Right, well, go and get Meg and join me in the staff room.
Anyone else?
No, not just yet. Be discreet about it. We don't want a huge fuss. There's no need to ruin Joyce and Mervyn's night if we don't have to.
I don't smell anything burning, so it must be a breakout. Well, I might as well introduce Dan the man, Moulton. He's going to be our new chaplain here.
Thanks, Rita. I'll be starting work next week. Looking forward to getting to know you all.
Feelings mutual, eh, girl?
Pat's gone to find Joan.
Better get Andrew looked at, too.
A shame. I want the whole building searched top to bottom.
I'll start with this floor if you like.
I'll do the solitary wing. Pat and Joan can do the other floors.
Make it thorough.
They really love the one about the water. Yay! I don't remember even rehearsing.
Oh, look, it just came to me. I think I read in the paper.
Hey, tell Max the one about the bloke on the desert
island.
Oh, yeah.
No, no, no. I don't want to hear it if it's filthy.
Hey, is this the fruit?
No.
You give it to her then?
No, she didn't want it.
Where is
is it?
I ate it.
You what? Well, like I said, she didn't want it. Don't know why you wanted to waste it on her anyway. Hey, anything up?
No, no. Look, did you enjoy it?
Oh, it was real good.
Yeah, well, that's the main thing.
You can have the other one as well if you like.
Oh, great.
Now, don't you say a word, Chook.
Look, she's gonna...
Yeah.
Didn't see a thing. It just came from nowhere.
Keep your head back. The doctor's on his way. The sooner he looks at this, the better.
Oh, I really ought to be helping with the search.
Don't move. I've got all that under control.
You're all right. Something was up. I think you better come and have a look.
Mervyn and Mrs. Barry, this is from all of us to you with our love and our best wishes. We hope you've had a wonderful day that you'll always remember. And we wish you a happy and prosperous future, and may God bless you both.
Well, it's just beautiful. The whole evening's been really lovely, and I just want to thank you all very much.
Well, Joyce and I would just like to say that when people want to do something like this for you, well, it means a lot. We'll never forget it.
Can I have your attention, please? I'm more sorry than I can say to end the evening like this, and I wouldn't if there were any choice. All officers are to report back on duty immediately, and the women are to be locked in their cells until the police arrive. An officer's been assaulted, and a prisoner's been found dead in her cell. She's been murdered.
Who is it? Who is
it? It's Lou Kelly.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing